set your DVRs. If you want to have the record button on, I'll give you a moment. This could be classic, folks.
Burtis?
Yes, sir, Burtis.
How you doing, man?
I'm doing just fine. How you doing, Steve?
Good, good, good. I'm doing good. What do you do, man?
I'm a mad scientist, Steve. Yes, sir. That's right. Seriously.
Yeah.
In real life.
Point values are double. We got top seven answers on the board. Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Darcy.
A gerbil.
No. I didn't say that.
Yes, 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 you said it. You said it. Let me just write out like that.
That's awesome.
Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Bam! Gerbil! Gerbil! Name something you shouldn't leave out in the open at your house when people come to visit.
Your dildos.
Well, y'all heard it, didn't you? Pick them up. All this out on the coffee table, and all this stuff in here on the kitchen table. And who laid this on the plate? Name a part of your body a blindfolded person might touch and think belong to a woman.
Their private parts.
Name something people do and then blame the dog. Raina.
Pee on the couch.
What's...
I don't do that.
You don't do that? The pastor don't even do that. What was all that for?
It's praying.
Yep, it's just a game here. He's not involved in this. Pretty sure he's got a little bit tied up with a couple other things. Got some wars going on, got some little oil cleanup going on, stuff like that. Kind of be a little bit tied up for the family. Yeah. Eddie, this is a minister.
The preacher going down!
Come on.
Watch this.
Come on.
See that? Watch out now.
Eddie don't care nothing about this man being a preacher. Eddie go, preacher going down.
Preacher going down.
What the preacher said, come on.
Come on.
All right. It's the church I'm going to where fighting is allowed.
Yeah, that's right.
Randy, only one strike, man. What would you do if you noticed your boss forgot to zip up his fly?
Zip it up for him.
Name a word that rhymes with song.
Bong.
Yeah. Bong.
Mm-hmm.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer. Not that I would know, I'm just saying.
Well, you know, your mom and daddy clapping, but I don't know why. Bong. Wow. Answers on the board. Name something a person might be referring to when they ask, is it firm? Victor.
Penis.
This dude right here. First thing, you just got on the show. Who got to ask you that? His thing. Angie, only one strike. Name something a man has to hide from his wife when he's having an affair.
His dirty underwear.
That's good, Steve.
Thank you.
Brian, your mama right now. Pretty shame of you right now, boy. Magic, name a state with beautiful beaches.
Alabama. Gulf Shores.
What?
Yeah.
Good answer.
It's up there, Steve.
Good answer.
Oh, Gulf Shores of Alabama.
Alabama.
Boy,
Gulf
I was
Shores.
Not pulling that one up right there.
It's a good answer.
Oh, yeah.
It's there, Steve.
I know it is, baby. They floods down there every chance I get. As soon as I want to go to a beach, I'm straight to Alabama.
That's right.
Leave that right there. The Alabama beach is on the Gulf Shore. We dared 100 married men to fill in the blank. My wife has a really big what? Paul.
Mouth.
Mouth. Yeah. Name something you could tell needs to be replaced just by the smell.
Air freshener?
Let me just go to the board. I can't work. I can't figure out what you mean by that. Air freshener! Brenda?
Yes, Mr. Harvey.
I'm so sorry because I just knew good and hell well that wasn't that good. All right, Tyler, only one. This is a pretty cool family, man. One strike, Tyler. Name something you can tell needs to be replaced just by the smell.
Your spouse?
Oh, God.
Tyler's replacing them just because of the smell. Smell! Name a place Grandpa goes with his Viagra. Francesca.
Golfing.
Well, if he can do that, I'm gonna have to get some of that. Grandpa goes golfing, he took his Viagra. Name a place that Grandpa goes with his Viagra.
A house of ill repute.
The house of ill repute. Oh, we're going to hell for this one right here.
Maybe.
All right, Amy. No, ain't no doubt about it. I can feel it. Name a place Grandpa goes with his Viagra.
He goes in his car parking in the Overlook.
Name a place Grandpa goes with his Viagra.
To the nursing home.
Yeah. Name something a date shows you. His collection of that tells you he's not for you.
Oh. His underwear.
I don't want to see nobody with no funny looking underwear.
That's right. That's well, right. Let's go on up there and see if it's up there. Collection of underwear. Who has that? Name some information you wouldn't want to be the last one at the office to know about.
There's a layoff.
There is a layoff.
All right.
Listen to me. Let's get this straight. Let me talk to your Carlisle family right now. See these answers up here? Your objective, once you see one, is to guess the one that ain't turned over yet. We don't need y'all reading what's on the board. Most of these people have an education. Sometimes you gotta go over the rules again. Top five answers on the board. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your mouth.
Yeah. On Uncle Jesse, name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your mouth.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Bam! Boom.
Try that thing. Got to nail it. Fly that plane, boy. What a good answer. Go on, Jesse. That's a good answer there, Jesse. No, I got this. No. I got, let me do this right here. I like people like this. That's just why I come to work. I know you want me to stop taking out this misery, but just let me, please, Monique, please. I know you won't say it because you love me. Sometimes when you meet crazy people, what you gotta do is you gotta let them go all the way out. You gotta let them, when you see them, let them go, boy. He said, no. Monique, I know you want to save me, because you can't stand to see it. Because you know why you can't stand to see it? Because you know this is on tape. Uncle Jesse, what's your answer again, Jesse?
Your mouth.
Your mouth. That was, boy, that was a good answer. Jesse, let me ask you something over there.
Yes, sir.
You really believe that's up there, don't you?
I believe so. It should be.
It should be? What a good answer. Let me ask you something. How you gonna feel if it ain't up there? About that small? About that small? Well, I think you're about to feel maybe this small. I know, Miss Monique. I know you won't stop. You ready, Jesse?
I'm ready.
All right. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear. You're just gonna stay with that. All right, cool. That's what I need. Yeah. Come here, Uncle Jesse. Come here.
Yes, sir.
Come here. No, don't talk to him. Sit right there. Right there.
Number three.
Get your ass over there somehow. Oh, I let him go. I let him have all that. Monique was over here dying. She was saying, Mr. Harvey, please, sir. Oh, no, I love moments like this.
Showtime.
All right, Jesse, let's try it again. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your feet.
Name something people complain is clingy.
I always have a kid hanging from my legs because I have 5 children. So, your children, your kids.
Yeah, that's a great answer. That's good. Woo, that's good. Surprise. Boy, I love this boy right here.
I'm waiting, Steve.
No, let me go ahead. I love this boy right here. You know, everybody in here in on this. Woo, J.E., you standing there waiting on it. Is it up there? Folks, is it up there?
Yeah!
Steve, hurry up, man!
Steve, look at the board.
Oh. All right, J.E. Karen, we've only got one strike. Besides family, name someone rich people might leave money to in their will.
Their relatives?
Yeah. I know that. These some nice people right here. Bob and Karen are nice people. This lady could be my mama. I don't want to just tell her no. I know relatives is family. I know that. It's in the question. Yeah, but what you want me to do? You want me to just tell her that ain't up there? I got to find a kinder way to do it. Miss Karen. besides family, somebody other than relative.
Universities or schools?
There you go.
Yeah! Good answer. Good answer. Real good answer.
Universities or schools? Here we go. Name something of yours that your dog eats, and all you can do is wait for it to come out the other end.
A piece of jewelry.
Piece of jewelry. Patrice, name something of yours that your dog eats, and all you can do is wait for it to come out the other end.
My diamonds?
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. That's a great answer. Outstanding. Damn. How in the world did you ever think of that? Girl, you so crazy. You ready, Catrice? Okay, just go ahead and read the board.
Okay.
Read the board.
All right.
You looking at it?
I'm looking at it.
Do you see it up there anywhere?
You know what? I have faith.
Yeah. Ooh. Mm-hmm. You right there.
It's up there.
It's up there?
Number six.
Really?
Really. Watch this.
Oh. Hey. No. No. You watch this.
Okay.
Okay. What's your answer, Gee?
Diamonds.
Diamonds?
My diamonds,
my
yes.
My diamonds. Yeah, diamonds. Go ahead. You shut up. All right. Number one.
Oh.
Give me a word or phrase that means naked.
Can I say naked?
Kayla, what do you do for a living, darling?
I'm a full-time student at Valdosta State University.
What's your major?
Sociology.
Oh, okay. So you hope to do what?
Graduate.
Good answer.
Say hello to him.
Hi, Cole and Noah.
Cole and Noah?
Cole and Noah.
Oh, Cole and Noah. All right. What do you do for a living, darling?
I am a hemodialysis technician.
That's good. Kenan?
Yeah.
What is she talking about?
Well, she just go to work.
She just go to work?
She just go to work.
What does she do, Ken?
Well,
first of all, do you know what she does?
Actually, not really.
Name something about Papa Olive Oil might think was sexy.
His pipe.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that. Well, my mind, woo. His pipe! Name a place no one wants to go. Vino.
Jail.
Jail. Charles. Church. Something a woman wants a matching set of.
A purse, like a bag. Yes?
Good answer!
When last time you seen a woman had two purses, huh? Who wants to carry two purses? Who does that? That's a guy. See, this is stupid. Frank. Show Frank the matching purses! Name something you might do while in the shower.
Urinate, Steve. Let it go.
Say something.
Say time.
I ain't tripping on that answer. I don't know. You can sit here and act like you don't, but whoo, I find it refreshing. Urinate! 100 men named something Shaquille O'Neal has is bigger than yours.
I'm gonna go with hands.
He's got, well, that's a body part. That's a body
I'm gonna
part.
Go with junk.
That's all body parts? That's totally separate. I got news for you. When a guy refers to little... I gotta tell you, I know you're the judge here, but I just got to tell you, that's a totally separate item. That's handled differently. It's set aside differently. It's cared for. It's protected with our life. Now, what would you say if a date asked you if your breasts were real?
Well, I had fed four girls with them.
Y'all ain't... See, listen to me. Pay attention, people. This is a gold mine. As a professional comedian, this is pure... This is like the greatest... And I get to go over there. I get to go talk to two dudes in some Oshkosh jumpers. Ricky, only one strike. Name a reason a man might ask for his money back at a strip club.
Because you went into a male strip club by mistake?
Whoa! I want my money back. I want my money
Come
back.
Come on, folks. He didn't know Peanut was coming out. Went into a male strip club. What? By mistake? How? Y'all ain't hear Vernon.
Nine people agree with it.
Yeah, Vernon. Yeah. That's right. Phil, name a word or phrase that starts with hip.
I'm hoping this is right, Steve. Hip, hippo, hip, like hiccup, hip.
You got the hip ups. You want me to scare you or something? You the first person I ever met had the hip ups. If that's up there, I'ma shoot myself in the teeth on national TV. And I'm gonna send the tape to TMZ. JT, name something that starts with the word ding.
Well, Steve, I'm gonna go with ding around the rosy.
Family, here's your chance. Name something that starts with the word ding.
Ding, ding.
What?
Ding, ding.
Ding, ding.
Yes.
Ding, ding. Yeah. You gotta be kidding me.
Ding, ding.
Ding. Go ahead, say it.
Ding, ding.
Ding, ding. Yeah, that's it. When your plane is getting ready to take off, name something you'd hate to see on the wing.
I would hate to see a food cart. Woo! Food cart. Turn around and say it. Food cart.
Yeah, you can repeat it as many times as you want to. About damn near bet everything I got in my wallet.
Point it, Steve.
And you ain't quit tapping me. And if I was you, I'd put your hand down. It's the food cart sitting out on the wing.
Yeah. Hi, Steve.
How you doing, baby?
I'm doing okay. How you doing?
I'm wonderful.
Oh.
I look so forward to coming down here.
Hey, I'm here.
I can't wait.
High five.
High five. Here we go. Ready?
All right.
Name something big a wife might tell her husband to get rid of.
His gun, Steve. Yeah! Yeah. Gun. Gun! Woo! His gun! Woo! His gun. All right, let's
just,
point.
But I'm talking about, but just fire her answer out like it's up there. His gun, Steve! Woo! His gun! Cow! Gun! Adrian, name something people say looks bright.
The stars, Steve.
I know, that's good. I know. That's the best answer you done gave, girl.
Give me five. Woo!
Now, that's
right.
Up there.
Give me another five. Woo! One
that's
more five.
Up,
woo!
Hell yeah. That's up there.
Woo, woo,
woo, woo, woo, turn them up.
Let's party together.
Star, party together. Stars! Up there.
In your face.
In your face. Stars.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ooh, you got me now.
I know. Yeah. I let you work yourself up and everything. Stop. You got so good to it. She said, in your face. Yeah, yeah. No, 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 it's in our face. All right, now I need your real answer.
Lights.
Huh?
Lights.
Yes, wow. Yes.
Lights. You gonna get one. Look.
Lights.
Adrian?
Yes.
If you knew you were gonna die tomorrow, what would you spend money on tonight?
I will pay for my child college fund. Yeah. Woo! Yeah. Woo! Get him through college. Nurse, doctor, lawyer, judge.
That's good. That's real nice.
Thank you.
That's real nice.
Great parent.
That's good. Now, you do know that ain't gonna be up there, right?
Well, I hope it is, Steve.
I hope it is too, baby.
I do too. Don't be negative.
Well, but this is your second day playing?
Yes.
Second game. Ain't none of your answers been up there.
Two.
Stop saying two, cause don't nobody remember none of them answers. Every time I come down here, we get an X.
Well, this is gonna be three.
Okay, ding. You wanna turn it over? What was your answer again?
My answer to pay for child college fund.
That's Woo! Right. That's what you're gonna do on your last night. Pay for the child college fund. Let's go. Hey, Adrian, how you doing today?
I'm doing fine.
You're one of my favorite players.
I know. Oh.
You really are.
I'm
your flattered. Your spirit is outstanding.
Oh, give it up for me.
Yeah. Give it up for me. Just as crazy as you want to be. So tell everybody what you do for a living again.
I'm a nurse. I work at a nursing home. I like to bark. I'm married. And I also
whoa.
Like to sing.
Did you just say you married?
Yes, 6 years, September
Lord,
the 8th.
Mercy.
He's out in the audience.
Where?
Keon Neal, he's shy. Where?
Who? That's your wife? Name some news that makes you both happy and a little sad. Candy.
Death.
Well, Candy, do you know that just died and you went out and threw the big party?
Nobody, thankfully.
Okay, well, let's see what favors. A death! Name an occupation where someone wears a robe at work. Aaron.
What is a surgeon?
You thought we were playing Jeopardy?
For a second, just for a second.
What was your answer? No one's never asked me a question back. I don't understand your answer.
I said surgeon.
A surgeon. Oh. What is a surgeon? We talked to 100 men. Name a food you like to see a sexy woman eating.
I'm gonna guess a hot dog.
Mitchell, let me ask you something, man. Could you just try to get your mind somewhere else? You done went with popsicle. This end of the board down here has been popsicle, banana. Now we back to you, and it's a hot dog. Come on, Mitchell.
That's horrible.
The hot dog. Hey, Rob, only one strike. Name something a man might pick up on his way home from work.
Another woman.
Name something you hope you didn't do on the table while you were drunk.
I hope I didn't urinate on it.
Oh. Urinate! Kevin. Rob, if you heard someone talking about the boss, who you think they'd be discussing?
Their wife.
That's the wife. There's one answer left. If you heard someone talking about the boss, who would you think they were discussing?
Steve Harvey.
Oh. That's the right answer. Yeah.
It ain't up there. But that's a damn good answer, though. Steve Harvey. Name something you can pass.
You can pass a joint.
Yep, you get all that educated stuff over there, then you come over here and they just pass a joint, Steve. And they got in a circle, and that's what they came up with. You can pass a joint. Rob, tell me something a farmer's wife might accuse him of caring more about than her.
His farm equipment.
The farm, more specific.
His hoe?
I kid you not. I couldn't have wrote a joke better than that. Woo. That's the best damn answer I've ever heard as the host of Family Feud. No,
I really appreciate
that. Damn brilliant.
Thank you. Thank you, Steve. Thank you.
It ain't up there. But that is the best damn answer that ain't on the board I've ever heard. Uh-oh! Dog, I wish I'd have thought of that.
To get the ball rolling, I will start by introducing this lovely lady, Bethany, my ex-wife, the mother of these lovely children.
And are you married yet? Are you married yet?
I've been.
You've been married?
I have been, yeah.
Oh, well, hell, you in the club then. Excuse me one second, gorgeous. Okay. Could you step back? Step down here. You just stand right there just temporarily.
Okay.
John, come down here.
Hey,
y'all,
Steve.
Y'all want a hug, man?
Thanks, Steve.
Yeah. Thank you, man.
It'll be all right. Thank you, Steve. Stephanie, what does the new wife do when she knows the ex is stopping by?
I'm gonna switch it up a little bit. If everybody is cordial, maybe she fixes a nice meal.
Good answer.
Good answer, Stephanie. Kill him again.
What damn TV show is that?
Good answer. I am a pre-K teacher and a at-home mom with three beautiful children.
Yeah. You married?
Married for 22 lovely years.
Yeah. You know you're
to
here.
To the same man.
Yeah. Yeah.
What, you rubbing it in or something?
I sure am. Not too many people can say that.
Not too many people want to. We asked 100 married women, if you could change one part of your husband's body, what would it be? Joyce?
His penis. His penis.
His penis.
There's a theme.
Yeah,
I know, I come from a weird place. You were thinking it.
I was thinking it. I wasn't thinking a damn thing. I don't know your husband, but I think that's him with that happy town. He's having a rough day. This penis. Okay.
Yes.
We've asked 100 married women. Are you married?
No.
Okay. Well, she... No, Mr. Stupid Host. You think I'm gonna give up all this to some one guy?
Sorry, just...
We asked 100 married women, name someone who comes to your door that you might be tempted to have an affair with.
My husband's best friend.
Your husband's best friend. Her husband's best friend. Hey, yeah, there you go. Get your hair out the way, because I was just going to call you Lynn.
You call me whatever you want.
How old are you, Caitlin?
I'm 21.
Yeah, I can't call you anything. Fill in the blank. A woman might buy a huge bra so she can go to the market and shoplift what? Lauren. Stephanie.
A car.
A car. All right, guys, here we go. Point values are double. We've got the top 7 answers on the board. Name something from the kitchen you can use to get something cooking in the bedroom. Mike?
Gravy. What's up, though? Gravy. You'd be amazed. Imagination.
But then he did this. Hey. Pull a little bit out there. You be, hey. That boy learning something down at that college, ain't he? Gravy! Andrew.
An apron.
Lean in here a little bit. Lean in here a little bit. Apron.
You gonna play, of course.
Yeah, crazy. Big country ass boy. Put some gravy on. Name something associated with a chicken that a man might use when describing a woman.
I'm gonna say chicken smells good. She smells good.
She smells
good. Okay, good answer. Yeah.
That's all.
Hey. A cooked chicken.
Hey, girl. Hey, girl, you know you smell like fried chicken. Ooh, you doing something to me right now. Yeah, you smell like that to all the men. What is that, shake and bake? What you got in there? What you got? The smell! All right, we ask 100 men, name something you do when you realize you've run out of clean underwear. Right.
You get them from your wife, her drawers, her underwear.
You wear your wife's drawers?
If you're out.
You said you wear your wife's drawers. That's what you said. There's nothing to do with dirty underwear. That's a whole nother game. Shauna says that you just wear your wife's drawers. I'm not even turning around. Okay, Sammy, name a reason Tarzan might wear a black loincloth.
Maybe he wants to blend in. Blend into the jungle? Yes! Oh.
Maybe. Been a comedian a long time. Maybe he wants to blend in. Almost took offense. Oh. Oh, so it look like the black people in the jungle? Is that what you say? Q, how you feeling today, sir?
I'm doing well, Steve. How are you?
All right. Did you ever stop to think that maybe Miss Claus is only with Santa for the what?
The ding-a-ling, Steve.
Let me ask something, Q.
Yes.
In all of the bedtime stories you've heard about Santa, which one did you hear that made you think Santa was all that?
Not one, but I'm just guessing.
Let me think of what line could have threw you that way.
Ho, ho, ho.
Ding-a-ling. Yeah! Mary, give me a place you told a lie to save your skin.
Okay, I've never done this, but I'm gonna say church.
A church?
Good answer, good answer.
You've been in the Lord's house just lying? In church.
I want my choice, Steve. Don't do me like that.
Point values are double, guys. Top five answers on the board. Name a place people get romantic because there's a risk factor of getting caught. Miss Myrtle?
Church!
Huh? Pastor got the banging congregation, folks. We going down there this Sunday. Going down to Pastor Liam Church. Name something you keep on doing even though you know it's wrong. David.
Sex.
Sex. Top five answers on the board. Name a word or phrase that starts with pot.
Potato.
Potato.
Good answer.
It does. Why are y'all clapping?
Does it start with pot?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, it starts with pot. But we all know. No one says potato. It starts with pot. You know, the Potomac starts with pot. I'm gonna just start walking towards the Scott family.
Okay.
Nothing personal. I just want to just get a jump on it.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see if it's up there. Pot. Potato! I'm so sorry.
See,
don't walk away from me.
You're older, you know more than I do. Forgive me, please.
She's a wise woman.
Name a word or phrase that starts with pot.
Let's go with pot called the kettle black.
Pot called the kettle black.
Good answer, good answer.
Hey, the way this is going, who knows? Pot called the kettle black. Name something that goes up that you hope will come down.
My parents are gonna kill me, but a male's body part.
My sister.
That was good. That was good, right?
Are your parents over there?
Uh-huh.
Oh, now they're pointing down the line. She's a mom right there. All of the aunts. She's not mine. She be her right there. Male body part. We talked to 100 married men. Name something of yours that your friends make fun of.
Manhood.
I got some mean friends. Well, I'm a man. I ain't got no friends I done showed it to, so. hey, fellas, hey, you wanna see something? Your manhood, Father Steele. Name something a woman might put in her man's underwear as a prank.
Cream.
Cream. Skip. Something hopes a kid doesn't do while he's on his lap.
Reach into his crotch. I wouldn't want that to happen.
Name something a female magician might pull a rabbit out of.
Well, Steve, she may have to bend down and just pull it from under her skirt.
Woo! That's up there, Steve.
It's up there. She got to pull it
out skirt. Y'all ready for my grand finale? Yeah, but I'm finna reach up. For a while. I hope he's still living. Pull a rabbit, sketch a rabbit out your skirt.
Yeah. All right, Brian, name something a guy might have in his wallet that he wouldn't want his wife to find.
A receipt of him. From him buying something or being somewhere he wasn't supposed to be. So a receipt of it.
Good answer.
A receipt of being buying something and being somewhere. The receipt for being in something and buying something. Just a receipt. A receipt. Hey, we surveyed 100 people. We got the top 6 answers on the board. Name something you'd never want to see your father wearing. Angela.
Bikinis, draws, women lingerie.
You can't name all of that stuff. We're gonna have to go with the first answer, which is bikini.
I'm gonna have to say that they go and get hair transplants.
They go get what?
I didn't want to say it to you, but they get like hair transplants because they're going bald.
Well, I'm not going to get one because I'm 55.
You
stop
like
talking to me about it. Now. I'm not going to get one.
No, but and this I don't fits
stop
you.
Talking to me. Not going to get some plugs put in my hair. Midlife crisis, they go and put, I don't want to say it to you because you could use a bunch of them. Yours would cost millions to do because you don't have a lick of hair. You're so rubbish. Midlife crisis, go get your hair done. Tell me one good thing about being bald.
You don't have to comb it.
Oh. Yes.
That's the same as brushing it.
Can you repeat the question for me one time, Steve?
Tell me one good thing.
Just clarification.
I'm gonna get it for clarification. Yeah. You know what the hell I said. Sitting over here, me and you, the two only damn bald head people up here. Know good and well what I said. Steve, can you repeat your question? I need more time to think of something.
Yeah.
All right, man, tell me one good thing about being bald.
You look sexy.
We look sexy, and we don't even care if it ain't up there now. Look sexy.
Sexy like Steve.
One little player. Everybody over here. Yeah. All the bald head men in the building. Yeah. Get your sexy on, baby. Yeah. And you can do a lot of other things too with it at night.
Yes, sir.
That's all. How you feeling today,
sir? All right,
sir.
Mr. Steve, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Okay. Name something a woman should do very carefully if she isn't wearing any underwear.
She should be careful when she walking up the steps, Steve.
You know, I was just about to compliment him, tell him how proud I was of him and how I thought that was a wonderful answer because it has a strong chance of being up there. And then I looked over there, and right before I could get it out.
That's it. Yeah.
Careful walking up the stairs. What's up, Ramsey? How you doing?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Still dancing.
Got it. It's in my bones, baby.
Yeah.
What's up? Come on.
Just never thought about cutting it off.
Huh? Never, Steve.
Never.
Long as I can move, Steven.
Long as you can move.
Yeah.
So let's go, Ansel. Name someone you'd hate to discover you accidentally sent a sexy text to.
One of the boys. One of the homeboys, Steve.
One of your partners, your homeboy. It's a 30-minute show. We ain't got time for you all down there dancing after every answer. We got things to do. All right, Ansel, let me ask you this question. We asked 100 wives, name something you sneak into the house.
Steve, if they do it with groceries back, they'll bring a man in, Steve.
Hey guys, here we go. Top 8 answers are on the board. A man might dream of having 2 wives. Yes. Okay, here we go. Let me finish the question. A man might dream of having 2 wives, but then he'll also have 2 what? You can't play no more. This can't call Family Feud. This ain't hit the buzzer. This damn light won't come on.
My name fell off, Steve.
Huh?
My name fell off.
What the hell is going on over here? I mean, either that, you know, like we out at the park somewhere. I turned around, I went, where's your
man? You
name fell off, Steve. There it is right there. You there can't read it like that? You sure you ain't just put your name tag down here?
No. I want you to know who I am.
Right. Well, let's prop it up right here. Let's
all right,
it like
there we
that.
Go. Everybody gonna see. There you go, America.
There you go.
All right.
All right, Nicholas, let's go. I ain't even got to write no jokes over here. Hey. I just let them talk. It's okay, let's get on to question 2. Give me Megan, give me Brandy. Let's go. Megan?
Yes.
Welcome to the show. I said, give me Brandy, give me Megan. Megan just was... it's a game show, you're on TV. Your family's counting on you. If they called you near, your family's going, why are you staying here?
Triple, we've got the top four answers on the board. If they made a Judge Judy doll, name something it might come with. Marlene.
Blonde hair.
Blonde hair. Really? Blonde hair. Ryan.
A gavel.
A gavel.
We're gonna play.
Okay, thank you. Name something you wouldn't want an ambulance driver to do while he's rushing you to the hospital. Yvonne.
Drink.
Drink! Amy.
Crash.
Crash. Yeah.
It was so exciting.
Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
Okay, let's go.
I also teach Pilates, and I also teach,
teach
booty
Pilates.
Bar.
Teach Pilates?
Yeah, and what? Booty bar.
And what?
Booty bar.
Booty part, let's get to that. What, what does it do to
it
your booty?
Your booty.
It firms.
It lifts it and firms it.
Lifts it
yep.
and firms
it. Lifts it up.
Ladies, if you need it, lift it. If you're pushing a grocery cart at a grocery store, and when you turn the corner, you lose control. It gets away from you, and you just keep going in a circle. Probably need to come to the booty bar. Guys, here we go. We got the top seven answers are on the board. Tell me a traffic sign that best describes your love life. Melton?
Stop sign.
It's gonna be all right. You win some more money, something will happen. Okay. Stop sign! You wanna pass or play? They're gonna play, Kathy. Brandy, how you doing?
Good, I'm great.
Good, I know. You guys are some pretty good players, so let's get to it. Tell me a traffic sign that best describes your love life.
Okay, I already have two kids, so this is okay for me to say, slippery when wet.
Oh, no! Stop it. Stop it. We are trying to stay on the air. Little Miss Fast thing over here. Slippery when it's wet. Man. Melton, back to you. This is getting better now.
Definitely a hazardous road.
This guy, hey man. Yeah, Mel. Hang in there. Even if these answers ain't up there, you pretty much nailed in your love life. Hazardous road. Well, little sexy Brandy, you can save it for the family. Two stripes. If it's there, you're still in shape. If not, Turk family, get ready to steal. Brandy.
Four-way intersection.
What the hell is happening at your house? Four-way intersection. Chance to steal, get on the board first. Tell me a traffic sign that best describes your love life.
Do not enter.
Wow. This is ugly.
What is it?
For the points, do not enter. Hey, Melton, let's pay attention here. All these are for you.
Yes, sir.
Number four. Slow. Number five.
One way.
Number seven. Name something a man would be embarrassed to admit he likes to do in the bathtub.
Play with himself.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Don't know if I'm embarrassed to let you know he plays with himself in the bathtub. Name a game people play at parties that a couple might play in the bedroom.
I'm going to say hide and seek.
Good answer.
Yeah. What's going on in there, Jamila? Hide and seek. Yeah, how big is y'all bedroom? Yeah. Peekaboo, guess where I am? Come and get me. Ooh, is that you under there? Oh, is that? Is that you? Yeah, all right now. That's how you get how old are the kids again, Jamila?
5, 3, 2, and 1.
Bam, 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 bam!
I'm a good finder.
A lot of whether you get a man depends on how you answer this next question. Name a game people play at parties that a couple might play in the bedroom.
I declare war.
Good answer.
That explains it right there. I just said, depending on how you answer this question right here, got a lot to do with you being single. What the hell you do, you get naked, and as soon as you get naked, I declare war. I declare war. Name something a couple might buy to play doctor in the bedroom.
Let's go with some edible panties. Looking at me like, you know.
Hey, Rich.
Huh?
Now, uh-oh. I gotta ask you something.
Come on, Steve. No.
What doctor you been to that ate your drawers off?
Well, you did say play.
Oh, doctor. Play. Oh, we get a whole play.
I'm thinking about me and my wife playing.
All right.
You know.
Yeah, Daddy's still down there listening, though.
I know, right? You know I'm gonna get a whooping on the way home,
he
right?
He can't believe it. He down there grinning. What the hell's going on? He looked down. Well, edible undies.
I'm in 11th grade now. I'm a cheerleader at South Paulding High School.
What's your favorite move, Dawson?
I grab an ankle, right? And I grab the butt, right? I mean the bottom.
Well, I done it. Yeah. Come
and
on.
You.
Yeah.
Hey,
talking about something.
I mean,
now.
Hey, wait. Yeah. I mean.
Yeah, go ahead, Dawson. I'm listening. You go
right.
Ahead. Show me how you do.
All right, look. You gotta kind of get low, right?
That's where I stay right on there.
Right.
And you grab.
Now look. You got an ankle
more, and you got a derriere in your hand. Oh, geez.
Now the trick is, you gotta keep your eye. On the flyer.
I ain't nowhere in the world. I'll take
that. Oh, yeah. I mean, what else would you be looking at?
That's my boy.
That's your boy. Name something a teenager might be told to keep his hands off of
himself.
That's a good one.
You've all heard that. Keep your hands off yourself before you go blind. You done heard all that. Yourself! Tell me something a man has that he likes to polish.
His man part? Yeah, that's good. I'm not that I know from experience or anything.
Shut up. His man part.
Lipstick. Yeah. We have that.
Edible lipstick?
Yes, edible lipstick. Kissable lipstick.
Yes.
You lick it off, suck it off. I mean.
Look at your mama looking upside your head.
But I'm 27.
Girl, what you on TV talking about licking and sucking for? You know I raised you better than that. Say you suck again. Say you suck again. Edible lipstick. Oh. You've done this before. Come on. You're being brutally honest. Name a reason she might give a guy for not dating.
Now, I swear, I would not say that.
Yes, you would.
No, I wouldn't.
Oh, you wouldn't say
I wouldn't, but I think some girls might not because he's bald.
Because he's bald.
Yeah. But no, I'm not saying that.
Oh, no.
Come on.
Oh, no. Oh, no. You're not going to touch me after you said that one.
I swear. Not me.
I would never date you because of you, Mr. Baldy. You ask 100 women just like you, name something you'd like to do to Steve Harvey's head. This is not good.
Slap it! Yes, there you go, there you go.
Slap it.
Slap it.
All I try to do for women, and you down to drop kicking my head. Got your little funny one off. You got 2 strikes, you gotta be careful.
Sit on it!
Sit on it! Hey, church lady. Church lady, you don't wanna do that. I'll tell you right now, church lady, gonna have yourself in a real situation. Praise the Lord. Yeah, you're gonna have to call him in the midnight hour. If you... Sit on it! Mm-mm. Oh. Name something the Pillsbury Doughboy and your man have in common.
He's white.
Oh, man, that's funny to me. Man, that's the best answer I done heard. Name something a really bored stripper might be doing while giving a lap dance. Mimi. Kim.
Reading.
Wow.
Reading. Name something everybody knows about Cinderella. Dustin.
She was homeless.
That's pretty shocking to me. That's a new one. Question is, name something everybody knows about Cinderella. I think we've got some late breaking news here, folks. I don't know about you, but this is gonna send shockwaves through the next bedtime story community. Let's find out. Cinderella was homeless. Only one answer left, Rochelle. If it's there, you clear the board.
Okay.
Name a... Okay,
sorry.
Go ahead. Just go ahead. Don't worry about it. I'm just the host. Jack, sir, name something you hope doesn't fall apart while you're on it.
My wife.
Gene, name something that has to be licked. All right.
A woman.
At what age do a lot of men look like they should be wearing a bra?
15.
Well, name a famous Harry.
I think there's a Harry on the Three Stooges.
If they made a movie called Bad Grandma, what might you see Grandma do?
Prostituting.
Name a household object that gets thrown during a fight.
A knife.
Name something that starts with an F that makes you happy.
Fingers?
Give me something a hospital nurse might threaten to do to a misbehaving male patient.
I'm gonna give you an enema. Enema.
But what is this photo?
Right up
in there. I'm a jam this thing right here. I swear to God, I'm gonna throw it. I'm gonna make you bend over. I'm gonna be across the room and I'm gonna stay right in there.
Exactly.
Enema.
How about not tie the back of his gown?
Not tie the back of your gown. I personally don't really care. I leaves mine open. And when the doctor leave me in there too long, you know how they put you in that room and they don't come by? I go out in the hallway. I get everybody's attention. I see somebody up the hallway, I turn and ask for a doctor. I do. I've done it about 4 times. They get the doctor to your room right away. Name a reason other men envy you.
They envy you because you've got a good body, Steve. Physique.
Yeah!
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, folks. Thank you. No, it's okay. Thank you. I work on it all the time. Thank you. Seriously, I was on the internet in Hawaii on the beach. You know, I didn't have a shirt on. And one of the people that saw it went online and said, Steve Harvey, this how your body's supposed to look. He 26. I said, cool. I sent him a bank statement. Mr. Otto, how you doing today,
sir? I'm doing fine, Steve.
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
You performed at Super Bowl.
Yes, I did.
What you do?
Halftime performance at Super Bowl.
What you play?
I play trombone.
Gremlin, come on up. It's a different kind of family here. What are you majoring in?
Nanoscience.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Woo-hoo. There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nanoscience. There you go. Woo! That's hot.
It's exciting. It is exciting.
It is exciting. What is it?
Well, I would describe it, I study the quantum mechanic effects of biophysical systems.
And that's exciting.
I'm going to cure cancer.
Yeah!
Let me tell you something. If you say that's what it's going to be, that's how it starts. That's it funny. Starts with a vision and a dream.
Hey, Jake.
I like that, man. That's pretty sharp right there, Jake. That's nice.
Cufflinks and all.
Notice all that cufflinks. Presidential cufflinks.
Yeah. You've been to the White House.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Very fortunate.
Yes, sir.
Been to the White, been in the Oval Office. Took a picture with the President of the United States by myself. Cried when I took the picture because I couldn't believe I was ever going to be in the White House. I told him, I said, if my mama, Ilorsville Harvey, could see me right now, she'd be crying. She in heaven, she saw it, she was crying.
That's
I can
right.
promise you that. All right, Jordan, let's go, man. Let's get it. Come on over here. Where you going? your little short self walking back there for? I'm about to tell you to go back there yet. She just told him, what is y'all doing? We'll be right back. Fast Money.
I'm cold and there are wolves after me.